Hello everybody and welcome back to Steve on Steve Plays Ostalgie, the Berlin Wall. Now before I begin, I just want to ask you to like and subscribe if you want more of this kind of content. But yeah, this video I might sound a bit off. There's probably going to be a lot of cuts in this video because I've been having some just awful allergies and I'm just sniffling and sneezing all over, so hopefully it doesn't happen, but we'll just have to see. So yeah, in the last episode, let's unpause for a bit. We managed to set up more or less fine. We are stable. Westalgie is a bit high, but money is going up very nicely. Soon we will need it in about 3 months, so let's hope it keeps rising. But yeah, everything seems to be going just fine. Okay, some of our science is finished. Let's see. Great. Now we'll wait for automation to finish. So let's see, what bonuses does this actually give us? More budget, more sovereignty, more standard of living. Yeah, pretty good. It's pretty good. So yeah, as I've mentioned in the last video, soon the start of 1990, the USSR under Gorbachev is going to start, it's going to abandon Comic-Con, essentially. And we're going to have to rebuild our own. That takes 30 funds, so we're going to want to make sure we do that. Oh, the music in this game is amazing. I mean, socialist music in general is just great. Phil Greaves would be proud. Alright, what's happening here? Get around the wall. The government of the Hungarian People's Republic opened a checkpoint on the border with Austria near Sopron and continues to open others, wishing it seems to fully open the border. Austria, although neutral, but from it you can get to countries in the west, including in the FRG. Okay, will we try to prevent this? Yeah, we'll close the border. We don't want to liberalize, because as soon as we start liberalizing, everything will start slipping through our fingers. Parade for the 40th anniversary? Yes, we will hold a parade, but do not invite Gorbachev. That's good. Westalgie is quite high, that's hurting. Let's see, what can we do with Albania? Aha, we can restore relations with Albania, that's great. And when we will be able to form our own Comic-Con, we'll be able to invite them to the Union, which is nice. Yep, money's going good. We should be fine. We might have to cut the budget once or twice, but that should be fine. I don't think we've had to do it yet. Or at least, I don't remember really. We shouldn't have to, it should be fine. Yeah, our budget should be 30 by the turn of the year, which is great. Okay, something in Greece. Now, this is probably the usual, the Greek question. Soon there will be parliamentary elections in Greece. Now, the PASOK party, Pan-Hellenic Socialist Movement led by Andreas Papandreou, is in power with the left social democracy positions in political friendship with the socialist camp and the USSR. However, the situation has been aggravated by scandals, new democracy, okay. We could support the opposition. So we can support the ruling party. We can't support the fascists. Well, I mean, right-wing Democrats. So yeah, we'll help the ruling party. That didn't cost us any money, which is nice. The political support, financing, and competent work of our agents allowed PASOK to maintain its good image. Excellent. So, Greece we're trading with, which is nice. So, once the USSR falls apart, we'll be able to invite them into our union, which is lovely. Let's unpause. Soon the year will be over. Something else in the GDR? Battle of the Special Services. Now, this is a bit of a tricky event. I never really managed to figure out what to do with it. So, recent events related to the opposition growth of reformist ideas in the party and the people, despite the fact that our country has been stable for a long time, have pushed analysts of Special Service and party members to the idea that this opposition has an artificial external origin. Most likely in our territory, on the order of Gorbachev, there is a network of KGB agents trying to destabilize our country and push it to the path of perestroika. Having followed the course, the sources, and the members of its society, we probably will be able to uncover this work, however, if it is necessary to decide how to do it. It is possible to deploy propaganda by showing the true side of Gorbachev's promises that it will raise our popularity among the people and simplify the work of the special services, as all the people will rise up against the spies, but this means directly to go against the USSR. They can quietly catch agents and expel them to the USSR, taking care that they do not deploy the network anew, which will not give such a powerful propaganda effect. We will allow Gorbachev to convey his discontent. We'll allow Gorbachev to convey his our discontent. Wow, that's not grammar. Close enough. Basically, we'll make Gorbachev see that we don't like him. Or we can agree on holding the elections. Do we want to expand the intelligence forces against the spies? Quietly extradite them to the USSR. I think we'll do that. The special services started an investigation. It was not easy to uncover the work of the Soviet agents. He appreciated that we did not make a case to the public. We don't need it. Camp stability is high and it will soon be higher. Okay, something's in India. Indian Gambit. Ooh, pro-Soviet of the INC. Send money to support the INC. That was costly, but I think we'll manage. Oh, damn. Yep, we missed our opportunity for the provocation between the Pakistan and India. That's a shame. Oh, well. We'll have to manage without it. Okay, so Ostalgie is... Okay, wow, lots of stuff. Okay, Poland, so just went sock reformist, which is not great. Crisis of the government of the Polish People's Republic. Urgent news from Poland. The Solidarity trade union led by Lech Walesa succeeded in holding elections, as well as the pact that for many years members of the coalition with the poop. The United Peasants Party and the Democratic Party have become opposition. The PUP retained majority in the Sejm, which is the Polish parliament. Prime Minister also... It's basically reforming. Support the Polish communists diplomatically. Oh wow, that costs us a lot of funds. That's gonna be difficult. Let's provide military coordination. Yeah, we want to keep them in the camp. We want to prevent them from slipping any further. What's in the GDR? This service. Poland opened their borders. Yep, we're closing our borders. Borders will remain closed. Yeah, money situation is not as good as I hoped it would be, but we'll have to manage, I guess. It really is not great. Oh well. Oh, just having a bit of water. Let's see. Yeah, we really don't have the money to throw around like this. Oh. That was an abrupt change in the music, but okay. Speed up time a bit. We do have 1 month, so hopefully we'll be able to have around 30 by then. Ooh, okay, one more science finished. Great, let's do our... So that gave us... Ooh, great help for the budget and standard of living. That's awesome. So let's do mass introduction of video surveillance. Ostalgie, support of the people, unity the party. Yeah, sounds perfect. Money's going up, ooh, very nicely. We can look at our stuff, let's have view, let's see trade. We're exporting more than we're importing, which is great. That's a good balance of payments right there. Partners, ooh, look at those juicy partners. Tons of people we're trading with, that's great. State debt is 15, that's unfortunate. That's just how the game starts off with, and we're paying it off a small amount every week. Borders are all closed. That's great. We're getting less and less Soviet aid, but that's fine. We'll live without it. Sovereignty is pretty high, which is good. Ostalgie is pretty low in the West. Situations. Control in Afghanistan is low. Control in Yugoslavia is low. That's not great. Let's see statistics. So this basically shows how our country's been growing and doing compared to the real GDR. So, you know, by this point, November 89, they had 135% GDP growth, we had 163, that's pretty good. Human Development Index, 100, yep, they had the same. Deficit of goods, they had a 0% deficit of goods, we have a minus 8% deficit of goods, that's great. So in November 9th, they had a 2.5% growth of economy, and we've got just under, above, just around that as well. So we're doing a little bit better than the historical GDR, but hopefully we won't collapse. So that's kind of our short-term goal at the moment. All right, we have 30 money. That's perfect. We should be just fine. It's unfortunate that I couldn't get India, but Jesus. Lots of stuff happening. Alright, England. Favorable exchange. In Panama, General Noriega has been detained by representatives of the US administration and transported to Florida, where he must be brought before the court to answer the accusations of drug smuggling. However, Noriega's supporters have suggested that we replace the general with the help of our special services, then we will receive little thanks in return in the form of his account in European banks. So basically we're saving this dude in exchange for money. Oh my god, that's 8 money. Wow. I never realized how great this event was. Damn. That's awesome. Alright, what's happening in GDR? Kill Hitler. Wow, okay. As you remember, in our country there is such a people's enterprise as Robotron, which produces various electronic products. Several employees who have visited abroad notice countries with that the game industry is very developed in the West. Video games. Yeah, we'll fund some video games. Well, and this I think is the main event. Oh no, not yet. Preshay Brezhnev. The press attaché of the USSR Foreign Ministry, Gennady Gerasimov, said that the Soviet Union does not intend to interfere more in the internal affairs of other countries, also known as the Sinatra Doctrine. This means abandoning the Brezhnev Doctrine, which implied the preservation of Soviet influence in socialist countries with the use of any means, including military operations, such as the Warsaw Spring situation. So either we support Brezhnev Doctrine, which means we will support every socialist country. We will, wait, so what's the other? What are the alternatives? Okay, on the one hand, this gives us independence in our foreign and military and domestic policies. On the other, the USSR will no longer save us. Yep, that's fine. If we support the rejection of Brezhnev, then this will cause a positive reaction from the West and the people will like it. On the other hand, we can speak about the positive aspects on the Brezhnev Doctrine, calling on others, but this will lead to backlash. No, we'll support Brezhnev Doctrine. When a meeting with the representatives of Poland refused, Czechoslovakia agreed, Hungary refused. Not sure what that means. But Poland and Hungary refused whatever they refused because they have non-socialist governments, and that's understandable. Let's send some aid to Afghanistan, some humanitarian aid as well. Because we are swimming in the money, which we will spend all of it right now, very soon, in the next month, I think. Down with the reform, in consequence of deteriorating situation of the position of the socialist bloc, Armenia decides to organize new trade agreements and secretly enter into a secret alliance against liberal reforms. We can begin negotiations and join the alliance with Romania and involve other CMEA countries. Yeah, this is the trigger event for forming our own economic union. Similarly, the conservative wing of the Politburo, intelligence and generals say that this treaty will not be enough and offer to buy out nuclear weapons drones from Romania. Ooh. Yeah, no. Conclude an agreement and invite the Comic-Con countries. Excellent. So, okay, so Hungary and Poland have not joined in our secret alliance, which is unfortunate, but hopefully they will join after it actually happens. Yes, it's a bit difficult. Of course, Hungary starts as reformist because of Kadarism, which is an economic policy you can take at crisis in the Kremlin, which was the official like state doctrine of Hungarian leader Janos Kadar, which was also described as goulash communism, which is kind of a mix of Titoism and Brezhnev. It's strange, it's hard to describe. So yeah, the event should trigger now. Yep, there it is. Oh no, that's not it yet. Okay, it's coming soon though, in the next month, I'm pretty sure. In 1989, the part of the perestroika policy, the first partially free parliamentary elections were held. Even then, the CPSU received 1,900 from 2,200 seats. However, already in March 1990, the Third Congress of People's Deputies abolished Article 6 of the Constitution, which enshrined the leading role of the CPSU. That's dangerous. Other amendments were adopted to the Constitution, allowing a multi-party system. The first legal opposition party, the LDPSU, was registered in the USSR. However, we did not betray the ideas of Marxism in our country. The leading position of the ruling party in the framework of the National Front has been preserved until now. So, this basically lets us for free shuffle up our political system. So either we can make it a lot more electoral, we can make it... Oh no, we will... Wait, we will... This is basically what we have... No, this is what we have now. This will dissolve one of the parties. This will totally liberalize our elections. Or we can dissolve the opposition. I will do that. We dissolved our opposition. That increases Ostalgie a lot. Look at that, your star's gone green. In terms of, what's it called? Government, they become sock reformism. And our politics is one-party state. which is best, I believe, for stability. So let's see, let's go on. Ooh, lots of stuff. Bulgaria. Drivkov's reply. Recently in Bulgaria there was a coup attempt. The reformist wing of the BCP, I imagine that's the Bulgarian Communist Party, tried to remove Zhivkov at the plenum, which is like the party congress. But having been prepared in advance for such turn of events, the Bulgarian leader decisively defeated the opposition, called it an anti-party group, and began to clean the party of supporters of Petar Mladenov. Sure, the conservative leader made small concessions, which however did not go against his previous reform attempts. He allowed small business in the service sector, started creating SEZ, I'm not sure what that is. Should we congratulate our friend on success and continued cooperation? Or is it best not to incur the wrath of Moscow? No, we'll support Zhivkov. We want to keep the pact together. Look at that, we're still at 90 stability, that's great. We're forever friends with Bulgaria. Let's see, Monday demonstrations. Yeah, basically protests, and we'll send people with water cannons. That basically destroys Ostalgie by 30 points, which is great. So yeah, basically just crush the protest, but that's fine. Desperate times call for desperate measures. And I mean, despite this, apart from this, we haven't been doing anything too harsh. I mean, we really haven't. All we've done is dissolved opposition parties, but that's for the sake of stability. Also, it's, you know, it's Marxist theory, it's socialism, it's democratic centralism, it's as was written by Lenin and Marx, so we're only following the path of true socialism. And there it is, there's the event. Adulthood. The representatives of our delegation have just returned from an extraordinary session of the Council for Mutual Economic Assistance, the CMEA, Comecon. At the session, the Soviet side announced the refusal to provide assistance within the organization, the abolition of benefits, and the transition to market prices in the economic relationship. The stunned Czechoslovak delegation stated, but in that case we would have to leave the CMEA, to which the representative of the USSR replied, come on, yes please. Termination of mutual assistance will be very detrimental to our economy, so we need to do something. However, maybe this is the right moment to stop the corruption of Leninism from the Soviet side. Can we try to agree with countries that have remained faithful to the ideals of Marxism? And as we dissolve the old CMEA, we will create a new one. This is possible only if we can completely replace the USSR. So, we can either accept this and everything falls apart, or we can do this. Allocate money from the budget, we will defend the gains of Leninism. Look at that, 30 money gone. Our proposals found not only support from among the conservative party, part of the CMEA, but also from the liberal, who just had the idea of leaving CMEA under the guise of discord in its ranks. All that remains will be to support ourselves. Excellent, so if we look at economy, look at that redness. Look at this new badge, the new CMEA, and the Soviets are not in it, which is great. And we can start inviting people into it, which we'll do after we do this event. Velvet exchange, that's not great. According to our data, the president of Czechoslovakia, Gustav Husák, plans to make his successor, Marian Kalfa, one of the leaders of the Communist Party of Czechoslovakia. However, according to our intelligence, Kalfa sympathizes with liberal elites, or liberal ideas, I meant. So his appointment to the presidency can significantly change the political situation in Czechoslovakia. Well, since we have compromising evidence, we can hand it over to Gustav. So, we can show him this compromising materials, what will that do? However, we could also convince him to stay on this post. Of course, this will show the steadfastness. Yeah, we'll show him to persuade to stay in this post. Look at that, socialist camp stability, 99.5. Oh, it's beautiful. I think we can invite Syria into the camp now. Oh, look at that, into the Union of Mutual Economic Assistance. We can't invite Yugoslavia, but we can send them monetary help. Albania we can invite into the Union. Yep, there we go. And we invited them to the Warsaw Pact. That's beautiful. Now, Greece, we can invite them into the Union once the USSR falls apart and leaves the Warsaw Pact. Which is fine. Let's see, can we trade with Iran? No, our diplomatic reputation is too low. Too high. That's unfortunate. Let's see, DPRK, you want to join our union? Excellent. Now we have Korea in our union. Perfect. Who else? Cambodia? Nope. Laos. Myanmar. We're already trading with them. I don't think we can add many more people to our union. So yeah, I think everything's fine for now. We can continue. We can eventually even invite Egypt to our union, but we need to restore relations with them. But I'm not sure how we will be able to achieve that. So now that we've the USSR has abandoned the common the Comic-Con, we can actually start, you know, becoming a power. We can make GDR the greatest country. And yeah, I think that's a good way to end off this episode. We finally formed the new Council for Mutual Economic Assistance. We managed to retain all of the original Eastern Bloc countries in it, which is an achievement in and of itself. Of course, except Yugoslavia. Yugoslavia was never the Warsaw Pact, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they weren't. Albania was, but they left. But now they're gonna be back. Oh, they... Huh. Not sure what's up with that, but whatever, it doesn't matter. Oh yeah, we got to invite them to the Warsaw Pact. Yeah, yeah, cool. Because they already were in the Warsaw Pact a bunch a while ago. So yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. As I mentioned, like and subscribe, and leave any comments or questions in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer them. And yeah, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.